Škoda has launched the Lauren and Clement variant of the Kodiaq in India at ₹35.99 lakhs. The car was first showcased at this year's Geneva Motor Show. The Kodiaq LNK sees extensive use of chrome on the outside, especially around the grille and rear diffuser. On the inside, the car looks like a cockpit with a large display screen showing all the information as well as 360-degree surround view system helped by four wide-angle cameras placed all around the car. The LNK is powered by a 150 HP 2-litre diesel engine. The engine is mated to an automatic gearbox which sends power to all the four wheels. Sao Paulo Motor Show is on and cars are being unveiled as we speak. Latest in that line is the Volkswagen Tarok pickup truck. The Tarok will rival the Fiat Toro pickup truck in South America. The Tarok shares an uncanny similarity with the T-Cross SUV, which was revealed recently in India, especially when it comes to some exterior elements as well as the MQB AO platform. Production spec Tarok will be powered by the 1.4-litre TSI petrol engine. Mercedes-Benz is all set for the launch of CLS Coupe on November 16th. Similar to the E-Class, the CLS Coupe comes with a much bolder design and added interior features. The CLS would be made available in both petrol and diesel guise with a 2-litre turbocharged diesel engine powering the diesel version. Transmission duties would be handled by a 9-speed automatic gearbox. On the inside, the CLS looks more like a modified E-Class. It has features such as 12.9-inch touchscreen infotainment system and a multi-function steering wheel. Autocar is reporting that Mahindra will launch the Altroz SUV in India on November 24th. Launch of the vehicle was slated to happen on 19th November. Now it has been pushed back to 24th. The Altroz will be Mahindra's new flagship SUV in India, replacing the SsangYong Rexton. The Altroz is based on the Rexton with a rugged body and Mahindra grille. In all likelihood, the Altroz will be launched in two different variants, a two-wheel drive G2 trim and a four-wheel drive G4 trim. Powering the car will be an 180 HP 2.2-litre diesel engine mated to an automatic transmission. In terms of price, the Altroz will sit above the Mahindra XUV 500 in the Indian auto market. Kia is planning to bring the Grand Carnival MPV to India to rival the likes of Toyota Innova. The Grand Carnival MPV likely to be launched in 2020 and its market research suggests that it could easily sell around 1,000 such MPVs here every month. The Grand Carnival is a 5-door MPV globally available in 7, 8 and 9-door configurations. The 7-seater seems the most likely option for India. The car would be offered with a diesel engine in India, which would likely be a 2-litre 150 HP unit. Price of the car is likely to be around the rupees 20 lakh mark. Fiat has teased a new SUV concept based on the Toro pickup ahead of the Sao Paulo Motor Show. A video has been released teasing this concept and it shows some of the design features of the car. A narrow crease running along the bonnet and the front bumper, a large grille, vents on the lower front bumper, fog lights and square wheel arches. Mechanical details of the car hasn't been revealed yet. Fiat plans to launch 3 new SUVs for markets across the globe. This new concept could well be a preview to what's more in store for the future from Fiat. The Tiago JTP and Tigor JTP has launched by Tata Motors at Rs 6.39 and Rs 7.49 lakhs respectively. Both the JTP models are performance-oriented and focus on improvement in engine output and acceleration, as well as having sportier design theme both inside and out. Design-wise, both the JTP versions remain identical to the standard variants, but do not have lower ride height and wider tires. Both the cars are powered by a 1.2-litre turbo petrol unit, making 114 HP and 150 Nm of torque. The engine comes mated to a 5-speed manual transmission. The Tata Harrier SUV is most likely to be introduced in January next year. Unveiling of the Harrier will take place a month prior to that in December 2018. Advance booking for the car has already started across the country and deliveries for the same will begin by the second half of January 2019. The Harrier made its debut as a concept during the 2018 Auto Expo, and since then, multiple teasers of the car have been released. The Harrier is slated to be a 5-seater car with a 7-seater version joining later on. Power plant of the Harrier would be a 140 HP 2-litre diesel engine mated to a 6-speed manual or automatic transmission. A special edition TVS Sport fitted with synchronized braking technology has been launched. Price of the bike has been kept at ₹40,088 and it sports new decals, new side view mirrors and a 3D logo. Features include all-gear electric start, sporty instrument cluster, chrome muffler guard and aluminium guard rail. The bike will be available in two color choices, black with red silver and black with blue silver. After various spy pictures tease the car, Tata Motors have taken the wraps off of the Harrier SUV. But wait, the car has not been fully unveiled yet. The company has just released a few images of the car, which gives us a glimpse into its exterior and design features. The Harrier stays true to the H5X concept, which we saw at the Auto Expo 2018. Design-wise, the Harrier gets a lot cladding, especially around the door. The car has big wheel arches, slit-like headlights, and spoiler atop the windscreen. Delivery of the car would begin in January next year, and in all likelihood, the car will be priced around ₹16 lakh mark.